On most of my dive expeditions, I'm just going down to observe. But today, I'm on a rescue mission. I'm going to rescue some juvenile fish. This might be hard to believe, but if I don't go get them, they will surely die.
Hi, I'm Jonathan Bird, and welcome to my world.
You see, every year, millions of tropical fish eggs from the Caribbean get caught in the Gulf Stream and take a ride up north where they hatch and grow for several months.
And a lot of these juvenile fish end up here off the coast of Rhode Island, a long way from home, more than 1,000 miles from the Caribbean. The problem is that when winter comes and this water gets cold, they'll die.
Even if we don't have our tank.
So every year, the New England Aquarium Dive Club organizes a tropical fish rescue. People come from miles around to try their hand at collecting tropical fish for the New England Aquarium exhibits. So I've come down to give it a try, but you know, I'm a little concerned because I've photographed a lot of fish, but I've never caught fish. I don't really know how to do it, and I'm concerned about actually hurting the fish. So I'm here with Michael Schrubin, who's an expert in collecting tropical fish, and he's going to help me out. Michael, can you tell me, is this hard? I mean, what do I need to know?
It's not hard. The biggest thing is to be calm. I've got all the tools, and I know where the fish are. I can show you how to do it.
Let's go.
All right.
All right, Michael, so show me this gear you have here. It's kind of interesting.
Well, it's funny. It's the various evolutions of catching tropicals. This is what I started out with. Which is a soda bottle with the end cut off of it. And if this were a rock, you put the soda bottle down and you just use your hand and get the fish in and you can see what kind of fish he is. This is the way I normally catch fish and have been for a long time. And what it is, it's a net, and the trick is this is the container that everything ends up in that I want. And it always keeps water going through it. There are holes in there, a valve to keep the fish from going back out. And if I don't want it, I can cap it off and let that animal out, the valve.
So we put on our suits, check our gear, and head into the water. The fish are small and they hide in the rocks in very shallow water, so Michael inches along looking closely at the bottom in search of them. Then his eye catches a juvenile butterfly fish, a baby tropical fish that looks out of place in New England. I watch as Michael easily catches the fish in his net. Does the fish have any idea of its fate as it descends through Michael's apparatus? Who knows, but one thing is certain. This little fish will die if we don't rescue it. Now it's my turn. I grab my net and start looking. Then I see what looks like a pea with a face bobbing in the water. It's a juvenile boxfish. I coax it into my net. This fish is so tiny, I'm afraid of hurting it, so as you can imagine, I'm very gentle. I slowly work the fish all the way down to my bottle. While we're looking for more fish to rescue, I'm startled to see a fully grown seahorse battered by the strong surge. I thought seahorses were exclusively tropical fish, but Michael says no.
I don't believe he is. A lot of people believe that he belongs in our water and can live in our cold water all the way up to Nova Scotia. It's something that most people never ever see and wouldn't believe that you could see in the North Atlantic.
Just to be sure, we decide to rescue him and check which species he is. He clings to the algae with his tail, and I have to coax him into the bottle with my hand. I could easily hurt him, so I'm super careful. To try and make him more comfortable, I bring some of the algae he likes into the bottle. He seems too large to be a juvenile, so I'm betting he's a full-time resident of these northern waters. After the dive, we check out the fish we rescued. Michael keeps them alive in a small aquarium until they reach their final home at the New England Aquarium. They will start out in a smaller tank, but as they grow, these fish will eventually end up in the 200,000-gallon giant ocean tank, the main attraction at the New England Aquarium. These three amigos will be on their way to the New England Aquarium within hours. The seahorse, as it turns out, is a local, so we'll let him go. It's been a long and perilous journey from the Caribbean, but thanks to the many volunteers, these fish have been spared a certain death from the cold winter water here in New England. Turns out, these guys will survive their ordeal and probably even thrive in their new homes.